The Los Angeles Clippers are getting ready for this matchup against the Boston Celtics. We now go to the Garden, where Mike and Jeff are set for the call.
Welcome to Boston, Massachusetts, as we get set for tonight's game between the Boston Celtics and the LA Clippers. Hello, everyone. Along with Jeff Van Gundy, Mike Green on hand. Both teams on the floor ready to go. So let's take a look at tonight's starting lineups. As we get things started, who on the Clippers do you think they need to keep an eye out for here tonight, Jeff?
You know, too often I think everyone talks about what Blake Griffin doesn't do well versus what he does do well. He's an exceptionally hard worker. Everyone in the Clipper organization acknowledges that. But he concentrates so much on his shooting, to me, that it takes away from what everyone should be noticing, which is he's a great runner. When he gets posted deep and early, he's hard to deal with because of his strength and athleticism. He's a much improved defender. Now, has his numbers gone downhill? Yes. Why? Because the addition of so many good teammates. But Blake Griffin is a very, very good NBA basketball player who helped the Clippers transform from a laughingstock into the most wins they've ever had.
Oh, excellent screen. To Green. Dumps it off beautifully to the rim, and the layup is good.
It looks simple, but it's hard to execute. Nothing more beautiful than a pick and roll when executed properly. Come off the screen, pass to the roll man. Roll man catches, an easy finish at the rim.
Green. To Lee. To Green. Excellent ball movement around the perimeter. Knocks it down as the shot clock expires. Yeah, that one's worth seeing again. Here's the replay. To Jordan. He shoots. Can't knock it down. Strong finish at the rim.
Home or away, that'll excite NBA fans. The dunk.
Strips him of the ball. Nice defensive play. 2 minutes gone by in the first. Boston down by two.
Oh, that's George Gervin-like right there. Contort your body, get it up and over the top of the shot clock.
To Olynyk. Oh, a ferocious dunk. Queued up and ready to go. Here's that play one more time.
That's the surest way to get 2 points. Take it hard to the rim and finish it with a dunk.
The Clippers looking to set it up. To Green. Inside, right there, and it won't fall. And he throws it down.
Oh, that's a nice dunk right there.
It's going to be a long year for the Celtics. Rajon Rondo hopefully will be completely healthy all season, coming back from his injury. But he's got to be saying to himself, where did everybody go?
And am I next? Because to me, that's the big decision for them. Is Rondo the piece you build around in this huge rebuilding project? Or does Danny Ainge decide, we're going to try to get all we can from him and really bottom out to try to hit it a home run in this upcoming draft and then rebuild truly from the ground floor. I think Rondo's a heck of a competitor and a really, really great player. And can he be as great a player when he has lesser weapons around him when the passing ability is his greatest strength?
Shoots it for two. Misses that one.
Olynyk.
And scores.
Alrighty, here's a chance to see that one again.
More players have to be able to do this. Finish over the top of shot block.
Dudley. All over him, still takes the shot. Puts it in, a two-pointer. And Blake Griffin with 8 points here in the first.
Lee.
To Green. Nice movement around the perimeter. Oh, he swats it. Hall. To Griffin. Two defenders, and he gets the shot off.
We've got that replay for you right now.
That's just tremendous defensive effort. You did all you could to prevent the make. Unfortunately, he stuck it.
To Green. Taken away by Dudley. Gets to the rim, unable to flip it in. Hall, nice soft touch at the rim.
Multiple shot opportunities. Great job on the offensive boards, not only securing the rebound, but finishing the play and continuing to build their lead.
To Lee. The catch and fire away from downtown. To Dudley. Griffin jumper knocks down the shot. An 8-0 run for the Clippers. For the layup, unable to flip it home. What a dunk.
Hey, you need to block out. You can't just go for an offensive rebound. You got to hit somebody. Make sure he doesn't get the rebound. Here, no contact, no block out. Good finish on the second shot opportunity.
Here come the Celtics. To Green, gets the wide open look for three. No go from beyond the arc. To the rim. No question. Yep, that's a foul called against the Celtics. Their first team foul.
What a trade for the Clippers as we see Chris Paul go to the free throw line. To be able to get a franchise elite talent with also a will to win that the Clippers have been missing. A killer. This guy has united this group from being a highlight reel show to a winning basketball team. I love what Paul has brought to the Clips on the court, but more importantly, he's brought the necessary leadership to help them close out tough, close games.
Dudley, lots of room there. Nails it from downtown off the quick release from Jared Dudley.
Can you say too easy? He is sitting there open at the three-point line and knocks it in.
High expectations in Clipperland. One of the key reasons, the guy who's running the team, Doc Rivers, now goes from Boston to L.A. What's he going to bring to the Clipper organization?
Well, when you let go of someone who accomplished as much as Vinny Del Negro, you have to make sure you replace him with a great, great basketball coach. And they did that with Doc Rivers. And Doc Rivers, this has been under-talked about. He is the decision maker with the Clippers. He has final say on personnel. So now he's got a Greg Popovichian type role in that he may not do all the legwork personnel-wise, but he has final say. And that brings great unity to an organization.
Right, Jump shot for two, won't go. Hall, looking to dupe the defense, draws the double team, puts it through.
Oh, that's nice right there. The finish at the rim with a nice dunk.
To Lee. Humphreys. There's an interception. A ferocious slam.
It only continues to get worse for the defensive team. Here, they give the ball up on a careless turnover and then
puts it in, plus the foul. Chris Paul picks up his first personal of the night.
That's great body control right there. Finishes the shot and now goes to the free throw line.
And that completes the three-point play. Out of bounds, turnover. Little personnel change going on right now. To Crawford. Fires for two. That's good. LA up by 16. There's the whistle. Here's the call. It's an offensive call against Rondo. Deflected, but they hold on a catch and shoot. This is his first shot. Crawford. Green. For two, cans the jumper.
A great shooter's never even noticed the defenders. He thought he was out in the park shooting by himself.
To the rim. He's fouled. And he'll head to the line to shoot two.
I really like what I saw there. Good strength, good athleticism. Took the foul, got up a nice shot, just didn't roll in.
Good free throw shooting, knocks down a pair. To Rondo. Green against Dudley. In the paint, and he draws the foul. And it's on to the line for a couple of free throws.
I really like this play right here. You're a great free throw shooter. Draw the contact and get two freebies.
Second one off the mark. He goes one for two. Jared Dudley with the ball in possession. Stripped away, stolen by Green. Puts it in for two. Tied up, has to make that pass. Crawford puts it up. Misses the two. Strong finish at the rim. And Chris Humphreys with strong defense to alter that shot. Boston brings it up into the front court. And a foul call against the Clippers. Third team foul.
Great effort to take that charge, but just a count late.